My name is Ben Chippy, and I'm from the Observatory. You all know Observatory, you all use it.
No, you want to talk.
Last time we presented, I went over some of the things that we were going to do, and now I'm going to talk to you what we actually did and what we're going to do for now. All like the bug fixes we wanted to do, those are all done. We implement some minor features, password recovery, past projects, past users, which was just updated. And both of those are all on both branches, the ARPA's production branch and also the master branch, so anyone who wants a generic copy can also use all the improvements we made. I'm also working on an easy setup tool. That's about 50 to 60% done. What it'll do is it automatically installs all dependencies, fetches the latest copy from the generic repo, and also goes through and starts to configure all the things you need from the mail server to send all the forgot passwords, to also setting up how often you want the fetch scripts to run, how many processes you want to run at a time, and just really personalize it to what you need. The next thing that we have on tap is like a test instance feature, which I'm going to talk a bit more about. We have some info on that. So the setup tools I was talking about, we have a generic installer. That part's done. It'll run on Ubuntu and any other Linux system that will use PostFix as primary mail server. There's another one that I was looking into, but PostFix is just a lot easier to set up automatically. So the setup configuration is a Python script that'll generate a copy of settings.py, which holds all the database connections, how often you want the scripts to run, how often they should time out, and all the other settings that actually make them run. And something that I noticed was missing was a database backup. So this will also generate a bash script just to run automatically to back the database where you want, how often you want, and have all the stuff that you want with them. So I'm just showing you a quick demo of new stuff. So this is just the same thing. You notice that not all the top tier projects are the same top tier projects here. Because I actually had a check-in, so you won't see just that gray block. You'll actually see a screenshot. So if you want your project to be featured, you need to upload a screenshot. If anyone has a question on how to do that, post a tutorial to the list. Now you'll notice that we have a much cleaner setup now, thanks to the patch products page. These are still being fetched, so you can still see how often they are updated, although those aren't being stored. So, go to people, and again, this is cleaned up, so you don't see the whole block of people. You can actually see who's actually being active, and then switch between the two. It's past and active. Just clean that up. And past developers can't log in, so if they try to log in, they'll get an error message saying your account has been deactivated, please contact a mentor. All that means is you're not currently working on it, so why would you be logging in? It's more like an NS spam thing. You forgot password, put in your email, you'll get a password within 1 to 2 minutes. It's been working pretty fast. It's just a random password generated by Python random, and everything else just works. So the idea of the task list is, in addition to the GitHub issues, which anyone can add on, the task list will really break down into what the primary goals of the project are right now and who's working on what thing. So let's say there's a project with users X and Y. That would be broken up into one big task list. But when you click on the user, you'll see the two tasks they're assigned to, so you know who's working on their own way, who's falling behind, and a better accountability of what is actually going on with the system. So we're going to implement that with Django To Do. This is just generic task list. As you can see, you can check off when tests are done, the priority, what they actually are, when they're created, when they're due, help you set deadlines. So you know, let's say you have a schedule, it'll show you exactly where you're behind schedule, where you're ahead of schedule. And also the owner and who's assigned to it. So I can make like a task and assign two other people to work on it along with myself, and the actual list. So you can have multiple tasks, like if you're working on more than one project, you can see what you're working on project A and also project B. So other considerations I came up with after working with Observatory a bit more in depth is a unique token to register. Lately, we've been having a lot of spam users come on, just register for the user account, not do anything else, and that's been screwing up with the database a little bit. So that's why if the project's having an infection, it's most likely to do that, because there was a discrepancy with number of projects, number of passwords, number of logs. Unless all those things are equal, it won't fetch because it'll try to look up doesn't exist or a bad user who doesn't exist. So the support for branch is more of a, let's say I'm working on something that's not quite ready to be pushed to master, but let's say I haven't been pushing to master in about 6 weeks because it's all this experimental development. Well, that just says I haven't been working on it 6 weeks. That's not what is actually going on. So in the case of the RPOS production versus master branch, I've been updating to RPOS production a lot, yet that hasn't been showing up on the observatory, which it's basically saying you're doing less work than you actually are. And just to the issues we're fetching repositories, that's basic span. And then the production server, someone ran a test code. I mean, where did you do that?
What happened?
Remember the issue that we had where, well, basically you run three scripts and everything just goes down really nice. Someone put untested code, so when that compiles, it crashes and you need to go track back and everything.
So there's also one other issue. When you put in rpos.rpa.edu/admin/something, instead of saying a page not found, it throws in database error.
Really?
Yeah. We can put admin.
That's the other thing. I don't really know how to log into this.
So you can register in RPOS. Do the go back and register.
Yeah, I actually don't have my password. That's the other thing we're going to look into, is being able to change the password, because right now it just has it set to a random 8-character of all large numbers, which is great if you're working on your own computer, it automatically saves, but when you try to log in somewhere else, you really don't know what it is.
Hope these guys are not playing trick here.
How long should commits to our repositories take to show up on Observatory?
I can check how often it's supposed to run. If it goes more than 3 or 4 days, let me know. Just shoot me an email and I can manually go and fetch it. As far as I know, everything should be up to date. As of this morning, I ran the fetch scripts. So, when's the last time you actually posted to the repository?
We might have done something more recently.
Okay.
It might have been delayed at least a day most of the time.
A day is pretty reasonable because it doesn't run every day. Just so that way there's less of a